I wanted to make an audio amplifier with a 741 chip. So I searched in old magazines and found in the Radio Bulletin, a Dutch magazine of 1974, on page 21, this circuit. And it looked very, very interesting to me. Of course, such a circuit needs a good power supply. It needs to be decoupled with a capacitor, etc., etc. But I also found one flaw in this circuit, and that's here. This resistor is shortcut, so that cannot work. That means that the schematic is okay, but it can never work because of the shortcut. The transistor here, the first transistor here, that has to drive the end transistor. This is a Darlington, and this is also a Darlington. A shortcut to ground, so it cannot work anyway. So I made a new circuit, a better circuit, and I will show that much better in the following minutes. And I also saw here that they used only one potentiometer here to set the bias of the circuit. This is a Darlington, this is a Darlington. It's driven by this transistor and also the preamplifier here, that is a 741 chip. Here are the pin connections of the 741 chip in a 14 pins setup. Anyway, I have used a 741 chip in the normal setup anyway, so I had to do some changes to the circuit. But it was a very, very interesting circuit, and I wanted to use it. So I made a amplifier on the basis of this schematic, and that is here. This is the amplifier that I made on the basis of that schematic of the Radio Bulletin magazine. And of course it had to be changed somewhat. And here you see the changes. And at the moment it does not work completely properly, especially on lower supply voltages. My idea is that the bias of the N transistors is not properly set with this combination, but anyway, it works, and I will demonstrate that. This is the decoupling unit here. It is in practice here 150 microfarad bridge with a, say, 270k resistor and a 100 nanofarad capacitor, always necessary to keep oscillations out of such a circuit. And I've made quite a few photographs, and I will show exactly in the future how I made this circuit. The bias of such a circuit is set by the voltage drop between these two transistors, and here we have a kind of, say, variable bias that is set by the BD139. I have on purpose used the BD-139 here, and also here, and here the BD-140, they can handle 80 volts, and that's good. That's the reason why I've used them, and they were not used in the original schematic of 1974. Anyway, here for everyone liking to do experiments, this is how I made the circuit in real. With all the connections, and here you often see bridges. That means that there is no connection between this wire and that wire. So, pan over somewhat again to show all these wiring and also all the bridged wires. Well, let's listen to how it works. Put in that music card. This looks, of course, quite good, but the issue is that this is 42 volts, and when the amplifier takes its current, my idea is that the bias is not properly, because now it's zero, so there is no quiescent current here. And I have to adapt that to make a better circuit here. So, a better circuit here, adapt this circuit here. And in other words, adapt this part of the circuit to get a better bias that it also works on, say, lower frequencies compared to now 42 volts. Anyway, interesting, of course, it works quite good. I have to do more tests. This is only a very coarse first result. I have not tested the whole circuit on, say, distortion, etc., etc., and what it really gives out in terms of power. Anyway, it works only on the higher voltages, and it is not properly biased. That's my first conclusion. But I'm surely gonna work further on this circuit. And well, I'm surely gonna get good results when I have, say, made some adaptations. You also heard distortion. That has everything to do with the biasing of this amplifier. And hum, but hum is no problem. Has to do in this case with the not proper shielding. So that's what you heard now. When the voltage dropped down, you heard a distortion. So that is all related to the biasing of this amplifier. Anyway, thanks for watching. Pan over the circuit somewhat. Here is the end capacitor. Here is the PNP power transistor, the 2N2955. Here is the end transistor, the NPN transistor, the 2N3055. And here a few power transistors, BD139 and BD140. BD140 is PNP, BD139 is NPN. And the pin connections are here, visible here. BD139 pin connections front, and here the BD140 is show that it's back, so that's here, back, the back side, and here it's the front side, that's black, and here we have the, say, kind of cooling plate. Anyway, so something to develop more about this circuit. Especially regarding the bias. And a good thing, we use here the 741 chip. That's in this case an audio preamp amplifier. And it was very good visible that when you change that 1 mega ohm potentiometer here to bias the 741, there's a very critical point, and that's, in my opinion, good. And in general, talking about this pre-audio amp and end-audio amp, when you change the capacitor here to a higher value, say 220 microfarad, more bass frequencies are amplified. The input capacitor, I always use a non-polar capacitor to prevent DC bias, DC entering the 741 stage. So this is completely galvanic galvanic separation here. And of course this circuit works. This is a classical, say, end amplifier made with a Darlington here and a Darlington there, and the bias is set by the voltage drop here from the base of this transistor to the base of that transistor, that's realized here with the help of a transistor that acts as a kind of Zener diode that keeps the voltage here constant on, say, perhaps 3 volts or so. That's the aim. So that's also the part that I have to study to get a better biasing of this amplifier. Anyway,